celebrate lots of Marine Corps birthdays know that sometimes you do them in really nice places, like hotels and ballrooms and places like San Diego, Las Vegas, and Reno, and Washington, D.C., New York City. And then sometimes you you celebrate them in places like this, in combat zones, and I've had the pleasure to celebrate the Marine Corps birthday in bombed-out buildings in Iraq and temples of Okinawa and places like that. And it's really special that no matter where you are on this day, you reflect on your time and your service and your comrades in the Marine Corps and our proud tradition of celebrating his birthday. So today was really special for us. The Sergeant Major and I and a few other Marines and chaplains, a few other Marines got to go. And this is the Sergeant Major's, I think, sixth or seventh piece of cake today. So he didn't get any chow tonight because of all that. But we had the pleasure to celebrate the birthday down at PP Wolfpack with 1st and 2nd LAR, and then in Gomsher with 1-3 and 3-3, and then in Fortinawa with Weapons 1-9, and then in Marja with some of the members of the RCT and 125, and then also with 3-6 in Marja, and then to come back here and cap it all off with the RCT and some of our supporting units, whatever, and it's just really a great day to celebrate the birthday here today and to celebrate our accomplishments as it were. I'll just leave you with two additional points. I think what the Marine Corps means to the nation, as was kind of captured in Lejeune's message, is that it's a victory-producing organization that the nation can put against impossible tasks and ensure that they achieve some level of victory. And I think as you look at the colors on the streamers on the 5th Marines colors behind me, those colors have stopped the Germans outside of Paris in World War I. Those colors landed on Guadalcanal and made an additional landing in World War II. Those colors landed in Incheon in Korea, many places in Vietnam. They were in Kuwait in 1991, in Baghdad in 2003, and then now in Afghanistan in 2011. And so it just represents the core, represents the ability for the nation to achieve victory. Like it was captured in the Commandant's message, that here in the last 10 years we've been called on to do some nearly impossible tasks, that of being the Anbar province in Iraq. And after several years of really hard fighting there, then, you know, we were able to produce a pretty significant victory and have set it up to be a really sustainable success. And then now for about 2.5 years in the Helmand province, which looked impossible a few years ago with the degree of kind of the nexus of narco traffic in Taliban and lack of troop presence down here, and kind of the tremendous opportunity that we've now given Afghanistan to move forward. And as we start to transition here over the next couple of years, and the tremendous opportunity that the Marines and Helmand province have given the nation of Afghanistan. So I would just, again, it's a proud day for the Marine Corps to be able to celebrate it. It was really special for us to be able to celebrate with all of our support units and then here tonight as well. The last thing I'll say is for the men behind me and all the Marines that are here today. The other thing that's special about the Corps is it's a group that that rather than sitting at home and complaining about how things are and how difficult things are and how things should be, you are all men and women of action who instead of complaining. You know, you pick up a rifle, and you come to foreign lands to change the way things are. And the Marine Corps has always been a hallmark of having men of action that have, instead of complaining about stuff, have picked up a rifle and done something about it, and rewritten history in a lot of places. And it's a true pleasure to have the opportunity to serve alongside you in Afghanistan here as the commander for RCT-5. But God bless you. Everybody else.
Thank you, guys. All of it. Yeah.